Yo, mambo vipi bana, wananiita mjiko mfalme ama ukipenda Dennis Milimo, and we have the privilege of hosting one of the biggest. Ndamuita, he's a pastor kwanza, alafu fashion icon, unajua kwanza. Kama unaweza ona, acha nisonge nyuma kidogo, look at the coat first. Mr. Burale, how are you, sir?
I'm very well, thank you.
Uko vizuri?
Nashukuru kabisa.
Good to see you.
Thank you. Always a pleasure bumping into you guys.
Yes.
Yes.
So today we are here for the official launch of Miss World Kenya.
Mr. and Miss.
Yes, Mr. and Miss World Kenya. It is making a comeback, but tuko hapo. What role are you playing? Because tumekuona pale kwa panel na nini, mko pale mbele.
Mr. and Miss World Kenya has been very close to my heart.
Yes.
I've worked closely with Madam Terry Mongai and the team. Actually, I trained even some of them before they left the country on speech, non-verbal communication.
Yeah.
And of course, Odada Okello trains them on the other stuff as well. So I've seen the journey. I've seen the tears. I've seen the laughters. I've seen the mockery. And I've seen the success.
Yes.
And why am I involved here? Because they go deeper into the inside of a person. Gone are the days where it's about showing your flesh.
Yes.
Ile lazima oneshe thighs ndio ukwe ni Miss Kenya pana. Now we have gone deeper that you can have the value system, you can dress well, be honorable, and still compete at the best.
Yeah.
Yes.
So there's somebody who's going to watch this interview out there, and they are probably willing to participate in this year's edition. What should they prepare for? Like in terms of making the preparations towards the biggest day.
You've seen the theme is about impact.
Yes.
So impact is not just makeup and all that. Anybody who wants to join this year's Mr. and Miss World, Mr. and Miss Kenya, really, Miss World Kenya.
Yes.
You got to have deep knowledge on matters, value system. How will you impact the society? What ideas do you have to save lives?
Yes.
You know, many years ago, it was about how you walk.
Yeah.
And that's it. But now, what do you have here? So what we see on the outside should be a manifestation of what is on the inside. Now that's why niko hapa. Mi mambo ya sijui kuonesha nyama kila pale ni stuck.
That is not your thing. Yeah.
It's impact. You know, this beauty competitions many years ago were mocked.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Because oh ni mambo ya them two hips, lips and fingertips. But now we are showing that men and women can look good, look decent, have brains, and impact society.
Nice.
Yes.
Sasa, towards this, you, in your youth days, uko nyuma, is it something?
Kwa maana amesema mimi ni mzee.
Moja kidogo. Pale nyuma.
Yes.
Did you ever, participate in, modeling, tuseme ukafika, one of the biggest stages, because mtu atangalia the way you dress, the way you always carry yourself, na nini, anasema, this guy, maybe, back in the days, he was a model, alikuwa na stage na nini. Is this something you have done?
I didn't go on stage. But I did a few TV commercials and TV shoots and branding and influencing for cloth lines and all that.
Yeah.
But never on the stage. My dressing was born from a very young age.
Yeah.
I just liked looking good. You understand?
Yeah.
Why? Because my father built a strong man on the inside and my mother as well. They made me feel good about myself. And then they introduced me to church. My identity is in Christ.
Yes.
So, ni kama mjaluo. Mjaluo akitoka kwa masidisi yake. Akitembea unajua huyu.
Huyu ni mjaluo.
So, for me, Christ was inculcated in me from my young age.
Yes.
Yes, along the way unapotea kidogo but unarudi. So, because I know of who I carry, then on the outside, I try my best to look good. So, I love looking good.
Yes.
In fact, today is an off day.
Si wengine sijui tutasemaje because leo ni kama tumekuja tu but we are
here. Sawa, sawa.
Si ndio? Sawa, sawa. So one of the things you are raising a teenager right now.
Yes.
Today akuja akwambie kwamba daddy I want to join probably modeling industry and what? Will you be at ease?
Yeah, because my daughter is a very solid girl.
Yeah.
Raised well. She has brain, she has wisdom. And modeling is no longer the modeling of many years ago, where it's about half-naked women.
Yeah.
It has become more honorable. So whatever she wants to be, I will support within parameters of honor and respectability.
Yeah.
You understand? I will not ask her to be a pastor. No. You come and see Pathia Kesia. Yes.
So it is not something that, unajua kitambo ilikuwa ngani wazazi wanaamua, what their kids should do. But in this generation, kidogo.
Oh, time, bro, times have changed.
Yeah.
These kids of nowadays have what they call an overload of information.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
yeah.
Pasho gives you guys information before news gives us information on
TV. That.
So they have an overload of information. Mm-hmm. You understand?
Yeah.
So when we were growing up, we didn't have much information.
Yes.
Even TV, if you can see OCP, you hear the Meisha. National anthem, Meisha.
You go.
But these kids are on phone. Mm-hmm. They have information. They have knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
They have more knowledge than we did.
Yeah, true.
During our time when we were the same age.
Yeah.
So by the time a child is coming to tell you, this is what I want to do, trust me.
Yes.
Atakupatia research yote amefanya.
Yeah. Nice.
They'll even have more information than you as an old person.
Manake wameanza kuinteract nayo.
Mapema sana.
Wameanza kujua kila kitu.
That's it.
At an early age.
Yes.
That is a nice thing. But for you, raising a teenage daughter, how is it for you? An easy thing? Unasema raisi ama...
Parenthood is a very beautiful thing, you know?
Yeah.
And I just need to make it clear.
Yeah.
You know, many people have this misconception that I'm raising her by myself.
Mm-hmm.
She has a brilliant mother who is raising her.
Yeah.
So she has become her own person. And every day as parents, all we're supposed to do is pray for our children.
Yeah.
Because out there, the world has become weakened. And I'm sure you guys know that. So as parents, and I urge every parent out there, all you can do for your children is pray for them, that they don't meet the wrong people.
Yes.
They don't meet bad things out there that for God to protect them.
Yes.
So raising children in this generation, in this era, is harder than when we were being raised.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Yeah, true.
Now there are too many things, too many, I mean, the phone has so much right there that they're competing for the attention of the young people.
Mm-hmm.
During my time, it was my father, my mother, my teacher, and my youth pastor.
Yes.
Now, TikTok, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, whatever. I mean, there are so many things competing. That's why when you see young people with their phones, no one is on their phone for 5 minutes without looking away.
Yeah.
They're just
scrolling.
That's information.
Yes.
Information.
Yes. The good and the bad.
All. So you pray that the young people, you can't stop them from even seeing the bad.
Mm-hmm.
But you pray that after seeing the bad, they will know which is the good and follow the good.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now, right now, for relationship, you have mentioned we are living in a generation, a modern world today. Relationship nowadays, they are bound, most of them, they are failing.
Yes.
Probably an advice to somebody who is looking forward to enter a relationship or somebody who is already there but trying to navigate aone. Hii yangu ita survive baka tuingie marriage na nini, especially the young people.
Melimo, what happens?
Yes.
Relationships don't end wrong. They start wrong.
They start wrong.
You go into a relationship because the girl has hips.
Mm-hmm.
You go to a relationship because the guy has a six-pack.
Mm-hmm.
15 years, the six-pack becomes like a one-pack.
Yeah.
What happens? You drop him, look for another person.
For another one.
So it is the foundation of a relationship.
Yes.
Why are you entering into that relationship?
Mm-hmm.
Nowadays, we see young people going into a relationship at 11 o'clock.
Yeah.
By 2 o'clock, they're celebrating 4 hours anniversary.
Yeah.
By 5 o'clock, they're banging each other like rabbits.
Yes.
Then they get tired quickly.
Yeah.
So we need to tell the young people,
what
is your foundation? What is your reason of entering into a relationship? To build each other. If you're going into marriage, it is courtship, not dating.
Yes.
Because dating is test driving.
Yeah.
Courtship is with marriage in view.
Yes.
So there's too much dating and very little courtship.
Uh-huh. So I think that is one of the biggest problems because we have not differentiated the two in this generation.
Dating ni kama kuenda kwa kayad, unajaribu, unaguruma, mafuta, unasema pana, haina freno, then you go to another one.
Yes.
But courtship,
we
are in this together.
Yes.
I want to know your values.
Mm-hmm.
I want to know your mid-term, short-term, and long-term plan.
Mm-hmm.
And once I know it, I want to connect with it because I want to be with you 10 years from now.
Yes.
But the young people now, on a Monday, if they reach Friday, it's a Thanksgiving service.
Yeah.
Because 7 days in a relationship is too long. So you just need to tell the young people.
Yeah, true.
And then, you know, they're meeting on TikTok, they're meeting on Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
And if you meet somebody and make a decision based on what you see on social media, then you just go and just do fleshly things. And then a week later, that's why there's too much depression.
Yes.
Jumping from a relationship to another, and then 6 months later, you feel wasted.
Yeah.
Young kids are so depressed. And that's why there's too much drugs.
Mm-hmm.
Why are people giving drugs?
Yeah.
Because they know there's a ready market of depressed kids.
Yes.
It's sad.
True.
And even you guys, I want you to be at the forefront of telling the young people, because the truth of the matter, you cannot deny the fact that you guys are one of the most, if not, most popular platforms.
Yes, true.
So use your platform also, because the young people listen to you guys.
True.
Tell the young people, kula happy ndio, lakini tembea vizuri.
Yes, responsible.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Sawa sawa. So I think pia, acha nione kama kuna swali nyingine. Oh, in today's world, beauty standards, have they changed from kitambo to now?
Unataka nichome?
Kidogo tu.
Beauty standards have changed.
Yes.
And to some extent, not for the better.
Not for the better.
No. Why?
Mazeta
choma, lakini sawa.
Ni sawa.
The problem is, you may meet somebody at 8 in the morning.
Yeah.
You meet the same person at 5 in the evening. They're two different people. Both men and women.
Yes.
Squeeze you on a six pack. Usikuwe sure ni six pack. Kuneza kwa investor mevaa hapo ndani. Ola cheki. Hata hizi mandevu lakini yako ni real nakaa. Hizi mandevu. Hizi mandevu unapomsana afika home anazitoa.
Anazitoa.
Alafu anaihang.
Anaihang.
Alafu anaispray asubuhi anairudisha.
Anairudisha.
I was seeing something on Facebook.
Yeah.
Dem anafunga leso.
Yeah. Oh, I saw that also. Like, yeah, true.
So, my take, and I'm not saying there's anything wrong with the beauty, but beauty is there, this beauty product, to enhance your beauty.
Yes.
Not to alter your look.
Your look.
People are altering their looks.
Yes.
Ukinyona seven, jioni mimi mtu mwingine.
Yeah.
Hapana. Enhance your beauty.
Yeah.
Do not alter your looks.
Yeah. That is a nice one.
Yes.
We are living in a generation right now. Social media is one of the biggest players in the lives that we live right now. Ministering for you also, tunakuona on social media most of the time, giving us advice, also preaching to us, kuna Facebook, kuna TikTok, kuna nini. There are pastors now who have taken it a notch higher. Let's say, for example, on TikTok now. Pia umeenda huko kutap-tap, kuitisha gift and all that. What is your take on that?
Our work as preachers, let me speak as a preacher.
Yeah.
Our work as preachers is to go to the highway and to the byway.
Yes.
We shall go to TikTok. We shall go to Facebook. But we should not smell like sheep. When a shepherd smells like the sheep, you cannot minister.
Yes.
Uwezi enda kwanza kukatia madem ati ni guza guza zo vitu zako. No. That is absolutely wrong.
Yes.
We are called to reach out to everybody. I talk to young people.
Yeah, true.
I talk to drunkards. I talk to people who are struggling with drug addiction. And like Jesus, we love them because we were once at a place where we were dealing with crazy things.
Yes.
And somebody loved us. But to be honest, where's the end of uko? Trying to rescue somebody.
And you become like
from
them.
Drinking.
Yes.
And then wanna chapa whiskey kualiko. It cannot be like that. And I know some people will not like what I'm saying.
Yes.
But there comes a time we have to stand firm.
Yes.
Tap all you want.
Mm-hmm.
But don't lose the focus on preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. Where's the end of Kuwambia?
So the purpose of you going to that platform should always remain.
You'd never change.
Yes.
Let me give an example.
Yeah.
You have asked me for an interview.
True.
Halfway in the interview, where's Niambia? Tukachapite pale nje. You know your purpose.
Yes.
Utarudi kwa ofisi. You gather what you have recorded.
Yes.
For the next level. But you enter TikTok, you start preaching halfway.
Yes. Unaanza kuwa kama wao.
Mpaka hao wanakuonea huruma, wanahopu okoke pia sasa.
True.
Yeah.
Yes.
Never lose the focus. Never lose, this is what I call, never lose the foundation of your assignment. Messi awezi ingia kwa kiwanja.
Yeah.
I halfway through in the defense. Kazi yake
is a striker. And he has to remain to the core.
And when you do what you're called to do, that's why he's the best player.
Yes.
As a preacher, you can go there.
Yes.
Let me tell you, I've gone on TikTok and I've danced.
Yes.
But I've not lost my assignment.
Yeah.
Siwezi enda kuambia madem, shikeni huku mbele, zifanyafanya hivi tuone. No. Bro, we're in the last days, bwana.
Yes.
Never lose your assignment.
Sawa. Ndio tusikuweke sana, but tumekuweka tayari.
And sawa, kuna China, ningoja.
And unajua kule unatoka, hiyo tutasema pole pole. T when is mentioned na wewe pamoja,
fever imeanza kwenda juu sababu si ya buhala hiyo. Unaona hata kichwa imeanza kufanya fanya hivi China.
Sasa Mr. Burale,
yes.
I want to our youth out there,
yes,
wafanye nini so that they can remain upright. Unajua saa hii the world we are living in, we have to be careful, but we always have to also talk to our young people so that they can walk the right way.
To the young people, I look here.
Yes.
To the young people, it is okay to have your fun, but within parameters of honor. It's just like a car has a speed governor. Make sure you walk right. Where if you overspeed when you crash, it may be fatal. But remember this statement that I've always told every young person. Where you stand in your days of youth will determine where you will sit when you grow older. So the table that is awaiting for you when you grow older will be prepared by the foundation in which you stand on the days of youth.
Yes.
If you go into drugs, you will never have a future. If you go sleeping around, you may never have a future. Let nobody lie to you that where the crowd is the right thing. Sometimes where the crowd is an indicator of where you should not go.
Nice.
Unless you're supporting Manchester United.
Asante sana. Thank you so much for speaking to us.
And I wish you guys the best. You're doing a fantastic job.
Thank you.
Keep on doing what you're doing.
Asante.
Enlighten us and God will bless you guys.
Asante sana.
God bless you.
Asante kabisa.
Saina ndakunywa chai, bora watu wameniweka. Asante.